Hey guys, welcome to Appalachia's Homestead. Pater here with a video for you today. We've all learned something new. We have hatched out some more babies. In fact, I would take the lid off, but we actually have more eggs pipping. So I want to leave the humidity really high in there and everybody drying off and everybody doing what they need to be doing. But we have hatched some beautiful cream leg bars and we're very excited about that. We also have some of our own babies in there. Long story, very short. Last week when I had to candle my eggs right before the lockdown period. If you don't know, chicken eggs take around 21 days to hatch. And there's a couple of points in that time period in which you'll want to candle your eggs to see if they're fertilized, to see if they're progressing. And then, of course, you want to candle them right before the lockdown period, which is day 18. Well, that's what I did. So I've never had this issue, but I had an accident. And things happen on a homestead. We've talked about that before. Life and death, things are unexpected. And you have to learn to be able to adapt. Well, this was a big learning curve for me. I was taking the lid off, no problem. I usually take about 2 eggs or so at a time, and I take them around the corner into our bathroom. The bathroom doesn't have a window, so when you shut the door, it's super dark. Well, that's what you want, candle eggs. You want super dark. You just have a really bright flashlight. And you candle to see the progression of the egg. Took the lid off, got the eggs out, and as I was beginning to try to put the lid back on for the others, one of the little eggs rolled off my hand, not a far roll, and hit the countertop. It wasn't a hard hit, but it was a good hit, just right, actually. And you could hear it begin to break, or it actually cracked. Well, I'm pretty good in stressful situations, actually. I stress about things that most people don't think about or things that are silly or can be handled, but this was pretty serious. So I thought immediately I've got to go get this in the bathroom and candle it, because if it's an egg that has not progressed or if it's an egg that's not, hasn't, you know, like I said, hasn't done very well, maybe it won't, you know, maybe it won't be a loss. Because even though you may be incubating eggs during that 21-day period, you do have some losses. That's pretty common. Maybe, you know, just a couple. So I took it in there, and no, the baby was alive. So here I am faced with the situation of right after the day of lockdown period, or right before, and I have a cracked egg. So if this baby doesn't make it, it's most likely my fault, right? So I came back, and I thought, what am I going to do here? We just cannot give up. I mean, I can't not give up. So I researched online very, very quickly. There's not a lot of information online, actually. So I just went with the first thing that I found, and I prayed on it. And believe it or not, scotch tape. This is no joke. I scotch taped the cracked seams, the fracture of the shell. Now, I read that you should not do this necessarily if it's seeping through, and mine was not, so that's a good thing. And like I said, it wasn't deep cracks or an indention, but there was fracturing, which was enough to make me panic. So, want to panic at least. So I scotch taped it, and I put it back in there, and I said a little prayer, and we just went forth with it. So that was egg number 2. I have numbered all my little eggs in here, and I left it alone. Yesterday, when the eggs started pipping, one of the other eggs was pipping, okay? And I thought, well, okay, here we go. I mean, we're on par, the timeline, in terms of when they're going to hatch out. And before I knew it, baby egg number 2 started rocking back and forth. So I just let it sit for a little while and kept an eye on it, kept going. So then I removed the incubator top. And I grabbed the egg and we started removing the tape, because if it's going to be pipping, especially if it's pipping in a certain area, you don't want the tape on that. And lo and behold, my pullet in here, this little dark girl right here, this sweetheart right there, that is egg number 2, if you can see her right there. And she is doing fantastic. So what is the lesson here? First of all, things happen on a homestead. Accidents happen, even if you, just in general. Okay, always use common sense, always try your best, but once in a while, you have spilled milk or you drop an egg on the floor, which that wasn't the case here, but you know what I mean. So my lesson here, I don't have a lesson in terms of how I could be more careful. I mean, I guess I could, but the lesson to me was don't give up. So always do your research, go with your gut, and it'll work out certainly for you. We have footage coming up next to show you how she hatched, and she's as strong as can be. So we're really pleased. So again, if you're interested in the cream leg bars, be sure to check out Olive Egg Farm. That's where we got these. And again, another testament to fabulous birds and product they put out of there. So we hope you enjoy seeing the footage of baby here coming out. And if you like what you see here, be sure to subscribe. Check us out on Facebook. We're also on Instagram, and we have our blog. And we just appreciate y'all. Y'all are great. We'll talk to you soon.